So you listened. The song that has been sung. You come to a point where you are back to God and you are asking Him today, Awashime, Jehovah. The day after tomorrow is coming, right? And you're thinking to yourself, I put this request. Does that mean that God is in heaven? Okay? On judgment day, whatever decision that I'm going to make during this COVID period, I'm going to be face to face with you. So the problem that we're having today, in essence, is we've been through a lot. We've lost loved ones. We've lost jobs. We've lost a lot of things that are dear to us. And during that course of the period, it can actually affect our decision making in life. We always talk about working on Sabbath. Some of us are going to start working on Sabbath because the smallest of peace jobs that we can find, you know, are very essential for our lives. Let us listen to the second song. Next song.
That's what we're here for.
But you still need to tell someone by the gate that rise up and walk in the name of the Lord.
We shall enter into a session of praise and worship. We shall be singing hymn 67.
Come we have a God of love, and let our joy be.
marching to Zion. How many of us are feeling the walk? How many of us have been hiking during this COVID season? Some of us, we never knew hiking in our lives. We've just been seeing posts, and then, you know, it looks pretty good, you know, when people are hiking there, you know, they're taking photos and stuff. But once you go hiking yourself, you really feel the difference. How many of us have been hiking? Right? Either going up the mountain, down the valley, and so forth, there's something that you feel when you're walking, when you're traveling. So there's that difference between you just knowing that there are people who can hike and you actually going through the experience. So this song which says you're marching to Zion on that beautiful mountain top, I feel like I'm hiking. So it's an experience that you have to go through.
We're going to ask our deacons, our deaconess, I believe, to come and serve us as we collect our offering. Can we please bow our heads and say a brief prayer? Father, as we at this time worship you through our giving, we ask that you may bless us accordingly, that whatever it is that we are parting with, you may restore. And not only may you restore, but you may restore it tenfold so that we may continue to give and that your work will continue to be propagated in this place. Bless us accordingly. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Deacons, deaconesses.
We shall use 136.
Thank you.
forevermore. You've been good to me, Lord.
Happy Sabbath, everybody.
Amen.
Happy Sabbath, church.
Amen.
You know, when I was speaking to Tom over the weekend, she said, you know what, Shimmy, we're going to do Thanksgiving. It's been a lot with COVID, and, you know, we're just going to praise God and say thank you. We're going to have testimony. And usually, I prefer to sing songs of hope. He'll do it again. God on the mountain. Cheers our language. But today, I thought, you know what? Let's just stop and say, thank you, God, for all the blessings, because we surely are blessed. This song says, I may never climb a mountain, I may never build a bridge that will last 100 years, even though I hope to, as a civil engineer, but it's saying that no matter what happens in life, we need to just stop and say, I am blessed.
Thank you. hide the smiles, so they look like you're not really happy to see me. But, well, the band could give me a track, but can you just sing this little chorus?
When I remember what the Lord has done, I will never go back anymore. When I remember what the Lord has done, I will never go back anymore.
Literally, first week of September, I But by the 7th of September, I'd lost my job. And it was like, you know those things when they say that you can make your plans, but God has the last word? That just came to pass into my life, and it was so hectic and it was sad. But somehow, you know when they say that He gives you peace that surpasses all understanding, I just had this peace about it. And I remember, look, most of you who've ever gone through a mutual separation, they pay you out for like 6-7 months. And at that time, I remember when I was speaking to one of the other pastors who also guides me, he was like, you have to tithe on that money. I'm like, ah, tithe on this money and I don't know when I'm going to get a job, you know? But something just told me that if you believe in God, He's also going to come through for you. Anyway, like Samu said, the shortest version is, literally I was out of a job for 3 weeks and I got another job again. And I was able to tithe even before the tithe was used up, another job came. So brothers and sisters, let us keep believing in God, because when we go through the hard and tough times, if we show Him that we trust Him, then He is going to also come through and believe in and, you know, do something for us. So even my husband, I remember when I was saying to him, no, we're going to do the gate for the church. And he was like, yo, the whole gate. I'm like, yes, we have to, I have committed, and I've committed to God that we're going to, you know, try and do more infrastructure for the church, so that when we believe in Him, He is also going to help us. So guys, please, especially for the church and every other thing, even in your neighborhood, give and it shall be given back to you. Press down, shaken together, running over. Amen.
Thank you, Sister Elena. Anybody else? Anybody else? Okay. I don't think we have any other hand. But I'll just say that as I conclude this session, that it's been a very, very difficult 3 years thereabout. Job losses. Many of us have fallen ill, and there were times when we were ill where we couldn't think. I remember when I got COVID, my friend called me every day, David, how are you today? And then I said to him, today I'm feeling much, much better. I'm even thinking about the future. And he says, you think you're fine. But really, you got to that point where you couldn't imagine yourself around next week or the week after that. Because your life was measured in minutes, literally. Your life was measured with gasps of breath. That's how difficult it was. And in that situation, we still lost friends and loved ones. Hardship didn't stop because we were going to pain. And yet God came through. He held us by His right hand and walked us through the valley of the shadow of death. We lost jobs, but we're here today. We lost some things that we owned, but we're still here today. So I'm here to say to anybody who's going through a hardship, who's going through a difficulty, Jesus is still able to do exceedingly, abundantly, more than you can think, ask, or imagine. Is that okay? Okay. Amen, church.
Just violent, today is the 19th, am I right? It's the 20th, right? Last year, the same month, it was on the 18th of November, DS was going to SRD for a recording. That day, it was a normal day. I woke up in the morning with my family, bed to go to the SRT. As we were passing certain hospital, I became very ill. I was taken into the emergency rooms. My wife was outside and talked to my wife. No one was allowed to be next to me. I just felt like I was crying. I couldn't say anything. I begged that my wife be brought inside to talk to. they refused because of the COVID conditions. The only thing I did, I managed to call back home to my two boys who were going back home. I couldn't actually tell them what was going on with me, but I just asked them to pray for me. And I want to thank the Lord that day the prayers were answered. I managed to go out of the emergency rooms the same day, just a few hours. And I proceeded with the group at SID, though I couldn't present, but I thank the Lord that He has allowed me to survive through until this day. So I thank the Lord because of that. Thank you.
Okay, I think my brother will have opened up the walls, the damn walls, and I like it.
Happy Sabbath, my name is Lisa, and I want to thank the Lord that next week I'm going to be born again. Next week I'm going to be baptized. So I want to thank the Lord for that.
Amen.
But because God is good, some of us can keep quiet.
Alright.
Because God is good.
Amen.
So people won't understand when we sing these choruses in church. In Genesis, they don't understand when you tell them. I'm fully hooked to person that had scratches was Gerald. And those scratches was because he hit the windscreen trying to get out of the car. A few other bruises, Bruno had back pains. Guys, the kids had no scratches whatsoever. There was grass all over Olinda's clothes. That's what I'm talking about. There was grass all over to show that something happened. But they had no scratches. Now ask me how that is possible. And then when I sing, Hakibaki,
thank you.
whatever she needed to come and give us the intercessory prayer.
Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory. Amen.
Thy will be done in my life as it is done in heaven. We have given testimonies, and I'm sure in this room we've got as many testimonies as the number of people in here. We all have stories to tell, but we don't have enough time. With all these things that the Lord has done for us, given the evidence of God's presence in your life, His goodness in your life, if you choose not to give your life to Him, not to live for Him, we're not going to blame the elders, the pastor, or anyone. It's your fault. Nobody's fault but yours. Nobody's fault but mine. Nobody's fault but mine. If I die and my soul be lost, it's nobody's fault but mine. Nobody's fault.
So, after all is said and done, apologies for me talking too much today. But God is good, it's not my fault. It's not his fault. But whose?
Mine.
But mine.
Yep.
You know what the funny thing is? If you look at it, all the goodness that's happening to you is not my fault. It's God. But all the bad that's happening within my space, or that I am doing, is whose fault? It's mine. But I'm not being punished. Is that not a bit queer? In a normal, like, Satan's purpose, the economists call it Satan's purpose. I'm the one who's doing the wrong. It's my fault. The good that I'm getting is God. But I'm not being punished. Literally, it could be that an eye for an eye. I sin today, God strikes me. Immediately. That's how good our God is. We're going to sing a song, Mind Your Feeling Power. It just depicts the picture of what God has for us. all the way my Savior leads me. Yonkinle, we are the home. All the way my Savior leads me.
Yeah. Thank you. Jesus,
Amen?
Amen.
It's time to go home. Are you sure? We could do this all day. When we were planning this program, one of the things that came up was the fact that Adventists need something to take home. Right? We can listen to the music and so on, but if they didn't hear a sermon, hey, yeah, it wasn't quite church. Are we together? Not quite, right? And because of that, we are not going to have a sermon. At all. I don't promise you that. If anything, we're just going to share something that you can take home. We will tick the box. We left you with a lesson that you can take home and you will feel uplifted. Amen? And in doing that, very quickly, we're going to turn to Psalms chapter 22, verse 3. Psalms chapter 22, verse 3. Psalms chapter 22, verse 3 reads, "Yet you are holy, enthroned on the praises of your people." Yet you are holy, enthroned on the praises of our people. It is from this verse that people speak the statement that says, God inhabits the praises of his people. So when we come together and when we praise God, God sits up. God takes note. And God feels that he is God. Right? And when we put God in that situation where we are praising him and he sits up and he takes note of us, what else does he do? He showers the blessings onto us. And very quickly, Acts chapter 16, I believe. There's the story of Paul and Silas, who were traveling on one of, I think it was the second missionary trip. And they were going through an area, I think in Macedonia. And as they were going through this area, there was a girl. And this girl was apparently possessed. And her owners, she was a slave girl, her owners used her to make money by lying to people about their fortunes, right? And as they were walking through this place, this girl takes note of them. And she starts following them. And the story tells us she followed them for a while, shouting, "These men are servants of the Most High." And they followed, and she followed and followed and followed and followed them. You can imagine when you're going wherever you're going and there's just someone behind you, following you and shouting and saying, "Oh, these people, blah, 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 blah." They're just going on and on and on and on. Irritating, right? Because that's exactly what the Word of God says. Paul got irritated. And in getting irritated, at some point it says he turned around and he rebuked the demon that was in this woman and she got cast out. They did a good thing, amen? But in doing this good thing, there were people that were not pleased. And the owners of this girl then said, "Ah, ha, ha, you've killed our business, boss. Huh? You've killed our business." So they took Paul and Silas, took them to the magistrate, beat them up, roughed them up, and eventually they ended up in jail. And the Word of God tells us that when they got into jail, and we all know jails are not five-star resorts, right? They got into jail and they were in trouble. What did they do? They began to sing. They began to sing. Why? Because God inhabits the praises of his people. They were in a situation where they needed to get whose attention? God's attention. And how did they get that? By praising. So we've had our share, I'm sure, of ups and downs and situations where we felt alone and frustrated and so forth. But if there's one thing that praise does, praise confuses the enemy.
Yeah.
And another thing that praise does, it gets his attention.
Yeah.
And in getting God's attention, the Word of God tells us that in that story, as they sang in the prison,
and everyone around them was listening, and some must have been thinking, are these men mad? You've just ended up in jail, and you're singing praises. In fact, the text uses the term praises. They were singing praise and worship, not singing lamenting songs. Oh, in peace, like, no, no. They were praising God. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let the earth hear his voice. They were praising, right? And in doing this, what does God do? Amazing things. They got his attention, and God does an amazing thing in this situation. So when all is said and done, and I'm reminded of the words of a song, I think it's on the latest Heritage Singers album. It says, when you're up against a struggle that shatters all your dreams and your hopes have been crushed by Satan's manifested schemes, and you feel the urge within you to submit to earthly fears, it says, don't let the faith, or don't let the faith you're standing in, disappear, but rather praise the Lord. He can work through those who praise him when you praise him. Our God inhabits our praises. So when you are in your situation, and no doubt, we're talking about reflections. We've gone through things, we've experienced things, and we will continue to do so. Amen? We will continue to go through things. But as we do, we have recourse. And that recourse is simply by turning around and praising God. Because when we praise God, the chains that seem to bind us, they're going to fall apart. The situation that we think has us totally contained is going to collapse. The same way the prison that Paul and Silas were in fell apart. So if you want to test God, if you want to see the power of God in whatever situation and circumstance you're going through, praise the Lord. Many songs come to mind. We've sung some beautiful songs today. Beautiful songs. But when all is said and done, there's a song for every occasion. Just keep that song in your heart. Now I'm remembering our Pathfinder song. Keep a song in your heart, right? And God will never forsake you when you praise him. Amen.
Amen.
You can take that home.
Amen.
Let's sing it in different languages, but we're going to conduct it in Zulu. So those are Xhosa hymns. Let's open them. Setswana, let's open. Venda, let's open. Let's bring the house down. All right.
Good afternoon, church. I hope everyone enjoyed playing. Can I see the hands of those who enjoyed? We are thankful to God for everything that He has done in our lives. And the song we're going to sing now means a lot to me. Sing the poem I can and Itanga. The song we're going to sing now says, "Sengilibona ikhaya engilithandayo." I think everyone that is sitting here today longs to be there one day in heaven. I think the goal and the purpose of us being here is one day we meet the Savior. Then, if we don't get to see why it is to be alive, and it happens that we sleep, let us long for that day when a moment shall spend, we shall see heaven.
Send Fefe Muti, Tahuba, O Tahuba.
Solace for once again, as always, being willing to come and worship with us. Divine Solace, in many ways, is a great voice of hope. Amen?
Amen.
Yes, so you do belong. Amen?
Amen.
Yes. So, they are ours, and as much as we allow them to go places, they must come home to us. So, thank you once again, and God bless you, madam, ministering to us in such a powerful way, as always. We're always so blessed when you're here. And we're looking forward already to the next quarter, where we will invite you once again. And we will require that you be here. Seraphim, as well, thank you once again. We see you a little more often, but we're always thrilled when you are here, when you're leading out and when you're praising God with us. Thank you very much. To everyone else who's contributed to this group, Shumi, thank you for that beautiful song. Everybody else who's helped out in any way, the communications team, the music team, the band, we want to acknowledge. Amen. It's quite an amazing addition to our whole praise and worship experience. And this is something that we want to normalize here. So by God's grace, we're going to be seeing more of this kind of thing going forward. And with that in mind, we are also very open to our own members getting involved in this sort of thing. So if you have a talent, if you have something that you would like to use towards God's praise and worship or any other aspect of our church experience, please come forward and let's speak about it and let's see how we can involve you so that together we are all sharing in the benefits of the blessings of God. That said, may God bless us as we depart. Next week will be another special Sabbath. One of the blessings that came out of the COVID era is the fact that many, 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 many babies who were born at Voice of Hope. Amen.
Amen.
And with all of these babies, there's that need for them to be dedicated.
Amen.
So next week, our babies are going to be dedicated. If you have a child who is not yet dedicated as of now, and you would like that child to be dedicated, we have a dedication service here next week. I would suggest you speak to either myself or Elder Mashinini as soon as possible, meaning today, and we will make sure that you are appropriately accommodated. In addition to the children's dedication and the children's program, we are also going to be having our first baptism in a few years. So continue to pray that God will lead and guide in the proceedings next week, that we will continue to grow as a church, that we will continue to fellowship together, and that in the meantime we will continue to stay safe and blessed. Let us bow our heads as we pray. Father, we thank you for the blessing that allows us to gather and praise and worship, to study your word, to interact in fellowship with others, and for the amazing experience we've had here. For every single effort and sacrifice that has been put into this day, Lord, I ask for a special blessing, that you may pour out that blessing on everybody who is here. Bless them abundantly. Take away any issues that might be burdening them or that might be challenging them. Continue to inspire us to aspire to become the people that you want us to be. Bless us now as we depart from this place. Keep us safe. Watch over us in Jesus' name.